this is Billy at Formsite, and here I'll show you how save and return works. Save and return allows your form visitors to save their progress and complete the form over multiple visits, or edit and resubmit previous results. The save and return settings are found by clicking Form Settings, then the Save and Return link. Let's see how it works. With Save and Return enabled, my form gets a Save Progress button next to the Submit or Next button. If I'm not logged in, clicking the Save button takes me to a page where I can create a new Save and Return account and then saves my form answers. The next time I visit the form, I can log in and my saved answers are already entered into the form. The form owner needs to decide whether logging in is required or optional. If it's required, we go to the Form Settings, Save and Return page, and set the setting to Always Require Login. That makes the login page the first page every time. If we want to make saving optional, we disable the Always Require Login setting and then add the Save and Return item to the top of the form. That item adds the button with the correct link to the login page. Be sure it appears before any other input fields, because clicking this link to log in will clear any completed fields. If you do not have Always Require Login set, you must have one save and return item at the top of your first page. Without that link, users are unable to find the login page. Let's look at the other settings. Allow user-created accounts lets me control whether visitors can make their own accounts or if only ones I've created are allowed to log in. You would usually enable this setting to let people create their own accounts. If you have a list of accounts to set up and you don't want to let other people access your form, you would not enable this setting. Allow updates after complete means once the visitor's form has been finally submitted, are they allowed to modify and resubmit their responses? If you don't want to let them change their answers after they submit the form, you would uncheck this setting. For repeat submissions or to allow edits to completed results, you would enable this setting. Allowing multiple results per account adds a Start New button to the visitor's results page, and disabling this setting only allows a single result per user account. If you want to allow more than one result per person, enable this setting. Allow Social Login puts buttons to create accounts and log in to the form for Google and Microsoft accounts. This lets people log in without needing to remember another username and password, and makes creating accounts on multiple forms easy. As mentioned earlier, the Always Require Login setting sends all visitors to the login page regardless of whether they use the regular form link or the Save and Return link. I can add text and images to the top and bottom of the login page using the provided text areas, which is useful for instructions, logos, and other important information. The area at the bottom contains the list of the form's accounts. An important thing to note is that these accounts are only for this form. Every form has its own separate account users, so they can use the same username and password or social login to set up accounts in more than one form, but they'll only see this form's results when they log in at this form's link. I can manually add accounts, either one at a time using the simple Add tab, or I can copy and paste a large number of accounts on the Bulk Add tab. The View Accounts tab shows the list of accounts for my form, and I can click the edit icon to change the username, password, and email address, or click the delete icon to remove the account. If I have a user who starts a result without logging in and wants to resume editing that result, or if they made a new account after starting a different result, I can assign their username to the result in the results table by clicking the username cell and choosing their username. If you have any questions about this or any other Formsite feature, you can reach us at formsite.com and clicking the contact link.